something trying to steal my mood. My crazy thoughts trying to kill my groove. That's when I hear a voice whisper through the noise that brings a bigger picture into view. Whenever the clouds come into my mind, I won't forget it's you who tells the sun to shine. Every birthday, every night, every second thought about tomorrow's space and time. Everything that you would choose to set your eyes on me, it blows my mind to think that you would know my name and I'm adored by the King of Kings. Whenever the clouds come into my mind, I won't forget it's you who tells the sun to shine. Every birthday, every night, every second thought about tomorrow's wasting time.
One time, break it down two times. Hey, listen up.
Why should I worry? Why should I care? 'Cause nobody loves me, no. Like you love me. Why should I worry? No. Why should I care? Every second thought about tomorrow's wasting time. Tennessee to wear me down. Am I really free if I'm thinking about only temporary things? The world's screaming so loud when I'm locked in the middle of my doubt. When I'm lost in the rhythm of the crowd, I hear heaven calling me. Don't wanna be another victim, falling prey to the system. When you've called me into the kingdom, to be glory bound. I can hardly keep my feet on the ground, 'cause I know I will be free. Lord, won't you open up the gates wide? Gonna step into a new life. No way I'm ever leaving your side. Oh, I know I am a citizen of heaven. My eternity forever.
Yeah. heaven. I've walked among the shadows, you wiped my tears away, and I felt the pain of heartbreak, and I've seen the brighter days, and I've prayed prayers to heaven from my lowest place, and I have held your blessings, God, you give and take away. No matter what I have, your grace is enough. No matter where I am, I'm standing in your love. On the mountains, I will bow my life to the one who set me there. In the valley, I will lift my eyes to the one who sees me there. When I'm standing on the mountain, I didn't get there on my own. When I'm walking through the valley, I know I am not alone. You're God of the hills and valleys, God of the hills and valleys, and I am not alone. I've watched my dreams get broken, in you I hope again. No matter what, I know I'm safe inside your hands. On the mountains, I will bow my life to the one who set me there. In the valley, I will lift my eyes to the one who sees me there. When I'm standing on the mountain, I didn't get there on my own. When I'm walking through the valley, I know I am not alone. You're God of the hills and valleys, hills and valleys, God of the hills and valleys, and I am not alone. Father, you give and take away every joy and every pain. Through it all, you will remain over it all. Father, you give and take away every joy.
No wall you won't kick down, lie you won't tear. you guys this morning. If you are visiting, a real warm welcome to you. We're going to kick off our service for today. We've got Joel that will lead us in worship. Dom's going to give us some pre-service announcements. If you have a Bible handy, grab it, or else on your screen there is a Bible in the menu bar. You can hit the menu bar and you can read along with us. But it's good for us to read scripture together. So grab a Bible while Dommies does the notices and turn to Psalm 95. We're going to read the first five verses to set us up. So to you, Dommies.
Thanks, Mike. Thank you. Yeah, well, good morning to you all. And yeah, it's been really lovely just to have a bit of crack with everybody this morning and interacting with you guys at home on the live chat there. A couple of notices, of course, just before we do start. And Joel and Mike bring our service to us this morning. If you are visiting, please, I do encourage you, hit that live connect button, say hello to us, let us see your name, and we can say hi back to you. And you'll also find out more about us as Cornerstone Church as well. The speed of the service and us juttering around and things like this all depends on your internet connection. If it's a little juttery and stuttery, click refresh and get back and join us as quick as you can. Indeed, as Mike said before, he's going to bring some verses from Psalm 95, and Joel will lead us in our worship. Mike.
Thanks, Dommy. So hopefully you've all got your Bibles. Psalm 95, let's read a couple of verses together. We'll read the first five verses. It says this, come. Actually, you know what? If you are sitting down on the couch, why don't you stand up? It's a good posture to be in. When we sit down, it's a bit complacent. Can be comfortable. But why don't we stand? If you're in your living room, I know it might feel a bit awkward, but stand. Get your Bibles out. Let's read some scripture. This is God's word, inspired by his Spirit. So Psalm 95 reads like this. Come, let us sing for joy to the Lord. Let us shout aloud to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before him with thanksgiving and extol him with music and song. For the Lord is the great God, the great King above all gods, and in his hands are the depths of the earth, and the mountain peaks belong to him. The sea is his, he made it, and his hands have formed dry land. Lord God, we want to come to you this morning and we want to sing. We want to worship. We want to shout aloud to the rock of our salvation, the one who is immovable, unshakable, consistent, the rock of our salvation. We want to come before you with thanksgiving this morning. We want to worship you and say, God, we thank you for the cross. We thank you, Jesus, for the price that you paid for us, that we are able to come together and to worship you in this weird way online. But God, we pray for an encounter with your Spirit. We pray for an encounter with the living God this morning. We want to extol you with music and with song because you are great. You are King above all kings. And Father, we worship you this morning. Yeah. And everyone said in one loud voice in your lounge, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Great. Thanks, Joel, for leading us together in worship today.
So good to be able to worship with you a bit more live this morning. Let's lift up our voices in our homes. Let our neighbors or our neighbors' babies hear our praises as we sing together. So let's worship.
Let our praise be your welcome. Let our songs be a sign. We are here for you. We are here for you. Let your breath come from heaven. Fill our hearts with your life. We are here for you. We are here for you. To you our hearts are open, nothing here is hidden. You are our one desire. You alone are holy, only you are worthy. God, let your fire fall down. Let us shout your anthem. You're renowned. Fill the skies. We are here for you. We are here for you. Let your word move in power. Let what's dead come to life. We are here for you. We are here for you. Oh, to you our hearts are open. Nothing here is hidden. You are our one desire. You alone are holy. Only you are worthy, God. Let your fire fall down. You, our hearts are open, nothing here is hidden. You are our one desire. You alone are holy, only you are worthy, God. Let your fire fall down. Oh, let it fall. Welcome you with praise, Almighty God of love. Be welcomed in this place. Let every heart adore, let every soul awake. Almighty God of love, be welcomed in this place. We welcome you with praise, we welcome you with praise. Almighty God of love, be welcomed in this place. Oh, be welcomed in this place. Open up our hearts, Lord. Open up our hearts. Open up our hearts.
He's coming.
He's coming on the clouds. Kings and kingdoms will bow down. And every chain will break as broken hearts declare his praise. Who can stop the Lord Almighty? Our God is the Lion. He's roaring with power and fighting our battles. Every knee will bow before him. Our God is the Lamb that was slain for the sins of the world. His blood breaks the chains. Every knee will bow before the Lion and the Lamb. Oh, every knee will bow before him. Every knee will bow.
Open up the gates.
Open up the gates. Make way before the King of Kings. Oh, our God who comes to save. He's here to set the captives free. Who can stop the Lord Almighty? Our God is the Lion of Judah. He's roaring with power and fighting our battles. Every knee will bow before him. Our God is the Lamb. For the sin. prisons of the world. His blood breaks the chains. Every knee will bow before the Lion and the Lamb. Oh, every knee will bow before him. Every knee will bow before him. Bow before you, Lord. So we bow the knee. We bow the knee.
We can stop.
And who can stop the Lord Almighty? And who can stop the Lord Almighty? Who can stop the Lord Almighty? Who can stop the Lord? There is no one. Who can stop the Lord Almighty? There is no one. Who can stop the Lord Almighty? There is no one. Who can stop the Lord Almighty? And who can stop the Lord? Yeah. No one can stop you, Lord. Our God. And our God is the Lion of Judah. He's roaring with power and fighting our battles. Every knee will bow before him. Our God is the Lamb. The Lamb that was slain for the sins of the world. His blood breaks the chains. And every knee will bow before the Lion and the Lamb. Oh, every knee will bow before him. Every knee will bow. Every knee will bow. So we bow the knee before the Lion and the Lamb. We bow the knee. In holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty. In His name with the sound of singing. Lift up his name in all the earth. Lift up your voice and give him glory. For he is worthy to be praised. And hold. Holy, holy. and is to come, who was and is to come, lift up his name with the sound of singing, lift up his name. Worthy to be praised, lift up his name with the sound of singing, lift up his name in all the earth, lift up your voice and give him glory, for he is worthy to be praised, for he is worthy to be praised, for he is worthy to be praised. You are worthy, Lord, and every knee will bow before the Lion and the Lamb, and every knee will bow before the Lion and the Lamb. Oh, every knee bow before him. For he is worthy to be praised. You are worthy to be praised.
Yes, Father, we want to lift your name high. Lord God, you are so awesome in all that you do. And Father, we want to say, who can stop you, Lord, even in this season? Who can stop the Lord God Almighty? Father, we thank you for your saving work by sending your son Jesus to die for us on a cross. That means that we can be free from the weight of sin. We can live lives passionately engaged with you, Father, as your Holy Spirit fills us and lifts up our eyes to you. You are worthy to be praised, O Holy God, Almighty King. Amen.
Thanks, Joel. Thanks for leading us in our worship this morning. And thank you. And just letting us absorb the awesomeness of God this morning. Just before Mike brings our sermon to us this morning, just a few notices to go through. Please bear with me as we make our way here. Indeed, we mentioned before in amongst our little bit prologue earlier that if you're visiting, and that might just be to the city in general or visiting us just this morning, or indeed if you're a new student, please make yourself known to us. Hit that connect button again. Let us know your name. Find out more about us as Cornerstone Church. We would love of course, to be doing that face-to-face. Mike mentioned about flat whites and donuts. We're a church built on flat whites and donuts, really, and we would love to have done that, but not so possible at the moment. Let us know that you're with us this morning, guys. Just some news about how we're getting on here with trying to get back to our in-person meetings and such things. There's been just another slight stumble block. Of course, everything is changing so fast with regards to the COVID-19 situation. And here at Bamborough House, where we meet as a church, unfortunately, they have postponed any bookings of their rooms until January now, which is a little bit, as I say, a stumble block, a bit of a blow. But we'll get there. We'll get there. There are plans. Our eldership and leadership team are looking into how we can still perhaps meet one way or another. So please keep this situation of meeting in person and meeting safely in person in your prayers. And hopefully we'll be doing something very soon as well. If you want to find out more about that and how the church is ongoing, again, hit connect, hit the visitors button, and indeed we'll be able to sign you up to our social media stuff and our emailing as well. If you have maybe changed any details recently, yeah, just update those details maybe on Church Suite as well, if there's been a change of telephone or email or home address as well. Church Suite. earlier on, guys were already asking for prayer. And again, I'll encourage you, if you have something on your heart, hit the live prayer button. The team are there waiting to maybe either message or indeed Zoom call with you and to pray through what's on your heart this morning. Please don't hesitate. Get that done and speak with somebody about what's on your heart for prayer this morning. One of the things, of course, that has been not so easy is if you give of your tithe here, normally at the church as part of our service, maybe it's in the box at the back. You can still do that. And there's a button which will come up on the screen to donate and to tithe online. As Christians, we're called to do that with a joyful heart. Again, things are not easy for lots of us at the moment. But again, we'll encourage you to pray and give with a joyful heart to support the work of the church here in the city as we're going through. You can hit that online tithe button whenever you want. Not a problem. Now, I'm here this morning and I'm fully aware that at my house it might be a little bit hectic with three little boys running around and my wife's hair getting quite frayed. If maybe that's a bit like you as well out there, or perhaps you're working, you've got shifts, we also have our evening service online as well, which is our recorded service. Join us there at 7:30, perhaps when things are a little more settled and a little bit easier for you to be involved with our worship and to hear our sermon, maybe without the distractions of family life or things like that. And indeed, as the bit prologue goes on, those selfies are still coming through. It's great to see faces like that. We're missing so many of you, even more so now with these local restrictions that are coming on. So, get those selfies taken as you're joining us on a Sunday morning. Get them sent in, church email or on church messenger. And Felix is doing a great job in putting everything together for us to keep up to speed with each other as well. Mike is going to be bringing our sermon to us this morning. And so can I just encourage you to open your hearts to what it is that God wants to speak through him this morning. Mike's going to speak to us.
Hey, Cornerstone, good to be with you again today. If you are new to Cornerstone, visiting us this morning, a warm welcome. Welcome to you. I hope that you find a home here with us at Cornerstone Church. Over the next 5 weeks, we want to speak into 5 values or cultures that we want to see developed or cultivated and invested in here at Cornerstone Church. So if you're new and you're visiting, please stick around for the next 5 weeks. This should hopefully give you a glimpse into what we believe. And if you've been here for a while and maybe you've attended one of our looking in sessions, you would potentially be familiar with these 5 headings. The 5 headings are spirit empowered, spirit led, and spirit filled. The other one is communities of love, life, and mission. The third one is humble, courageous, and sacrificial leadership. The fourth one is biblical teaching and training. And the fifth one is God-centered generosity. 5 cultures, 5 values that we want to see worked into the life of the church. And these 5 cultures will form the heading or the backdrop over the next 5 weeks. And we have purposefully called these cultures off the back of a sermon that I did back in 2018, which was on Matthew chapter 13. And in Matthew chapter 13, Jesus says that the kingdom of God is like leaven, that it is like yeast that a woman took and hid in 3 measures of flour till the whole batch was leavened or proved, or until the yeast had permeated the whole batch. Now, I don't bake bread. We have other people in our house that do that. But I do make pizza dough from time to time. And the amount of yeast that you use to make a batch of dough is really low. It's like a percent or two of the actual flour volume. And the thing is about yeast is that you can't really see it when it's mixed into the dough. But you know that it's there, firstly, because it gives the flavor to the dough. And secondly, you know that the yeast is there because of the effect that it has on the dough when it rises and it becomes all airy and puffy. And as a leadership team, we would love these 5 cultures to be like yeast in the batch of dough, that these cultures get kneaded into the fabric and into the DNA of who we are. That as we do this, they add flavor and they add texture to us, and that people will know whose we are. If you've ever made dough, you would know that it requires elbow grease. You can't fully rely upon the electric mixer to do all of the work when you make dough. And so when we speak about being a spirit-empowered and spirit-led people, what we do is we press into the things of the Spirit of God. We press into those things that are a little more unknown to us. Then instead of standing on the bank of the river, we rather wade in deeper. That when we speak about being a community of love, life, and mission, you involve yourself in your gospel community during the week. You contribute, you participate instead of just spectating. We move from just tasting the bread at the table to actually joining those who are making the bread in the kitchen. I hope you get the picture of what I mean, and it goes through the rest of those five cultures that we want to see worked out at Cornerstone Church. Peter Drucker is a business consultant, and he said that culture eats strategy for breakfast, meaning that we can have the best strategies in the world, but the culture that exists within that framework will always win. And this is why we've called this series Counter Culture. We are called as men and women to live counterculturally in this world. A kingdom culture is not about a geographical location, but it is more about being a distinct people under the lordship of Jesus Christ. And so today I want to speak about being a people that are spirit-led, being a people that are spirit-filled and spirit-empowered. And next week, Mark is going to preach on what it means to be a people of biblical teaching and training. And today my hope is that as a church, you and I would be men and women that are committed to the centrality and the authority of the Bible and to effective Christ-exalting operation of all of the spiritual gifts. And what I mean by that is that we would be a church of born-again followers of Jesus who are gospel-centered, who maintain a high view of the sovereignty of God and salvation, and those who delight in speaking in tongues, praying for the sick, prophesying to the edification and encouragement and the support of other believers. We want to be a local church that holds in biblical balance the foundational truth of God's written word and the supernatural movements of the Holy Spirit in and through spiritual gifts. Now, God's power comes to us in a variety of forms, but spiritual gifts are the primary expression of God's work in our midst. This is why we say that as men and women of Cornerstone, we want to be people who exercise all the gifts of the Holy Spirit for the common good of the church. So what does that mean? What does that mean when we say spirit-led, spirit-filled, spirit-empowered? Well, today I have four statements, and I will qualify each one and explain what I mean. They'll form our four headings for the day. The first one is, at Cornerstone, we believe that the work and the gifts of the Holy Spirit have not ceased and continue to be manifest in the local church today. See, spiritual gifts are God present and in, with, and through human thoughts, deeds, words, and love. I'll say that again. Spiritual gifts are God present and in, with, and through human thoughts, deeds, words, and love. You see, throughout the New Testament, there is a consistent and positive presence of all the spiritual gifts. Paul's first letter to the church in Corinth is a great example and warning to the local church of where he needed to correct the misuse of spiritual gifts. But this is not due to spiritual gifts, but rather to an immature people. See, beginning with Pentecost in Acts chapter 2 and continuing throughout the book of Acts, whenever the Holy Spirit is poured out on new believers, they experience the charismata. Charismata, this is the most familiar Greek term used by Paul, which refers to the gracious work of God. It's where we get the word charismatic from. You see, the gifts of the Spirit are evident when Paul speaks to the church in Rome, Romans chapter 12. The gifts of the Spirit are evident when Paul speaks to the church in Corinth, 1 Corinthians 12 to 14. In Samaria, Acts chapter 8. In Caesarea, in Antioch, in Ephesus, in Thessalonica, and in Galatia, they all experience the miraculous and revelatory gifts, speaking clearly about what a new covenant Christianity is supposed to look like. And so what does Paul say in his letter to the church in Corinth? If you've got your Bibles with you, turn with me to 1 Corinthians chapter 12. We'll be looking at quite a few of the verses in chapter 12 as well as in chapter 14. But let's read some scripture this morning. 1 Corinthians chapter 12 and verse 4, we'll read until verse 11. Now there are varieties of gifts, but the same Spirit. And there are varieties of service, but the same Lord. And there are varieties of activities, but it is the same God who empowers all in everyone. To each is given the manifestation of the Spirit for the common good. For to one is given through the Spirit the utterance of wisdom, and to another the utterance of knowledge according to the same Spirit. To another faith by the same Spirit. To another gifts of healing by the one Spirit. And to another the working of miracles. To another prophecy. To another the ability to distinguish between spirits. To another various kinds of tongues. To another the interpretation of tongues. All these are empowered by one and the same Spirit, who apportions to each one individually as he, the Spirit, wills. You see, Paul is saying in verse 7 that each one is given the manifestation of the Spirit for the common good of everyone. This is Paul's way of saying that the Holy Spirit is visually evident in our midst whenever the spiritual gifts are in use. Spiritual gifts are God, or is God, going public amongst us. You see, the universal church was established through the ministry of the apostles, but nowhere in the New Testament does it ever suggest that certain spiritual gifts were uniquely and exclusively tied to them, or that the gifts passed away with their passing. In 1 Corinthians 12 and verse 8, which we just read, this is what Paul writes. He says that spiritual gifts will not pass away until the coming of the perfect. And if the coming of the perfect is the accomplishing of God's redemptive purposes expressed in a new heavens and new earth following Christ's return, then you and I should confidently expect God to continue blessing and empowering his church with spiritual gifts until that time. And lastly, there is consistent testimony throughout most of church history concerning the miraculous gifts of the Spirit. The gifts have never ceased, nor have they disappeared from church life following the death of the last apostle in Scripture. Added to that, there is also personal experience in at least my life of the gifts of the Spirit. And so the gifts of the Spirit have not ceased to work and operate in our midst today. Secondly, we believe that the gifts of the Spirit are not for the spiritual elite, if there was ever such a thing. The gifts of the Spirit are not for the spiritual elite. They are for every believer. Every believer in Christ Jesus, the spiritual gifts are for them. 1 Corinthians 12 and verse 7. This is what Paul says. Now to each one is given the manifestation of the Spirit. That is, male and female, young and old. Spiritual gifts are not exclusive to elders. They're not exclusive to deacons or to ministry leaders or to some unique class of alleged super saints. See, apart from the apostles and other average Christians also exercised miraculous spiritual gifts. Briefly, a couple of examples would be Luke 10. Jesus sends out 72 people ahead of him. They cast out demons from people. Acts chapters 6 to 9 gives us three examples of men like Stephen and Philip and Ananias who were not elders, but they operated in the gifts of the Spirit. They were not apostles. We read about the church members in Antioch, Acts chapter 13, hearing God and prophesying, and even followers of John the Baptist in Ephesus, Acts 19, prophesying, speaking in tongues. We also don't see it necessary for an apostle or a church leader to be present either to pray or lay hands on people in order to receive spiritual gifts or in order for them to operate. In 1 Corinthians 12, we read that the sovereign Spirit gives prophecy, faith, miracles, and other supernatural manifestations to ordinary Christians in the church for the daily building up of the local church. You see, spiritual gifts are not roles. Roles are opportunities for ministry common to all and available to anyone. And what I mean by that is that all of us are to be witnesses for Jesus, but not all will have the gift of evangelism. You see, all of us are called to give and to be generous with our financial wealth, but not all of us will have the gift of giving. All of us are called to pray, but not all of us have the gift of intercession. And so in summary, the gifts of the Spirit are for every believer, every Christian. Thirdly, we want to see all the gifts of the Spirit manifest, encouraged, and desired here at Cornerstone Church. 1 Corinthians chapter 12 and verse 31, this is what Paul says to them. But earnestly desire the higher gifts, and I will show you a still more excellent way. 1 Corinthians 14, turn the page, 1 Corinthians 14 and verse 1, pursue love, earnestly desire the spiritual gifts, especially that you may prophesy. 1 Corinthians 14 and verse 12, so with yourselves, since you are eager for the manifestations of the Spirit, strive to excel in building up the church. A little bit further down, verse 39. So my brothers, earnestly desire to prophesy. Do not forbid speaking in tongues. Here Paul, on several occasions, is saying that they and us are to seek or to pursue spiritual gifts that we desire and that we don't yet have. Paul says, earnestly desire. Say that with me now. Say, earnestly desire. Paul says that we are to earnestly desire. These two words are not a suggestion. It's a command. And so if you and I aren't earnestly desiring spiritual gifts, especially prophecy, and we are disobeying what Paul wrote. You see, spiritual gifts like teaching and leadership and tongues and mercy and so on are more kind of a permanent gifts. And they can be expressed at will. Whereas I would say that the other gifts like prophecy, healing, miracles are always subject to the sovereign purpose and timing of the Holy Spirit. What I mean is that healing is dependent and is always subject to the sovereign will of God. You might have prayed for one person and God healed them, and yet the next person you prayed for did not get healed. The spiritual gift of healing is not dependent upon the individual, but rather a God-given ability to pray for healing, and it is subject to the sovereign purposes of God, whether they are healed or not. You see, healing is not subject to the will of man. It's subject to the will of God. So what are some of the spiritual gifts? You're in 1 Corinthians. You were in 14, go back to chapter 12. Let's read from verse 4. Now there are varieties of gifts, but the same Spirit. And there are varieties of service, but the same Lord. And there are varieties of activities, but it is the same God who empowers them all in everyone. To each is given the manifestation of the Spirit for the common good. For to one is given through the Spirit the utterance of wisdom, to another the utterance of knowledge according to the same Spirit, to another faith by the same Spirit, to another gifts of healing by the one Spirit, to another working of miracles, to another prophecy, to another the ability to distinguish between spirits, to another various kinds of tongues, to another the interpretation of those tongues. All these are empowered by one and the same Spirit, who apportions to each one individually as he wills. Oh, I wish we had the time, but we don't. And I think we should probably do another sermon series on the gifts of the Spirit. But what we see in this passage is that some of these spiritual gifts are words of wisdom, words of knowledge, words of the gift of faith, the gift of healing, the gift of miracles, the gift of prophecy and distinguishing your spirits, the gift of tongues and the interpretation of tongues. All of these spiritual gifts are given not for your edification or to make you feel good, but they are given for the building up and the encouragement of the local church. There's also the gift of mercy, the gift of teaching, serving, exhortation, giving, leadership, seen in Romans 12. But knowing what they are, having a knowledge of what they are, is kind of only halfway there. We need to possess the practical wisdom and the spiritual skill to know how and when and for whom these gifts are designated to operate. And so we need to pursue the Holy Spirit for them. But we should not push Him for them. We should ask Him in prayer. Paul says in 1 Corinthians 14, to pursue love and to earnestly desire the spiritual gifts, especially that you might prophesy. Go back a couple of chapters, chapter 12, he says, all these gifts are empowered by one and the same Spirit, who apportions to each one individually as he wills. This means the Holy Spirit is the one who decides who gets what. But we are told to earnestly desire. You and I are responsible for the desiring of the spiritual gifts, and the Holy Spirit is responsible for distributing them. And we should ask that He fulfill our desire by granting us the gifts we want to see manifest in our lives. Ask God. At the end, in our response time today, we just right where you sit, ask God for the impartation of the gifts of the Spirit. If you can't remember what they are, 1 Corinthians 12. Ask God. Ask Him to impart the gifts of the Spirit to you today. Lastly, our desire and prayer for you all is to encourage you to be filled with the Spirit on a continuous basis. You see, when we come to faith in Jesus, we are immersed or baptized in the Holy Spirit. He fills us and He dwells in our heart and in our lives. And so Spirit baptism is an instantaneous and coincident with our conversion, and all Christians are recipients of it. And baptism in the Spirit is permanent. It cannot be lost or forfeited. In Ephesians chapter 5, Paul says to the church in Ephesus, he says this, do not get drunk with wine, for that is debauchery, but be filled with the Spirit. The language that Paul uses is describing our continuous and ongoing experience of the Holy Spirit. To be filled with the Spirit results in power, in purity. It results in proclamation and praise, which we'll see a little bit later in Ephesians chapter 5. And so being filled with the Spirit is different to being baptized in the Spirit. There is one baptism, but there are multiple fillings. It's a command from Paul to the church in Ephesus. It's a command from Paul to be filled with the Holy Spirit. It's also possible to be baptized in the Spirit, whereby you experience this permanent indwelling of the Holy Spirit, and yet, like some of the Corinthian believers, not yet be filled with that Spirit. To be filled with the Spirit is to reflect maturity and character. It's kind of like the ideal condition for every believer. Because we are commanded by Paul to be filled implies that we as Christians face the danger of being low, but never empty. We are always in need of refreshing and renewal, and so we should seek for a filling of his Spirit. See, after Paul commands them to be filled with the Spirit, he speaks about the consequential evidence of this in verse 19 of Ephesians chapter 5. That's what Paul says, addressing one another. This is the evidence of the Spirit. Addressing one another in psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs, singing and making melody to the Lord with your heart, giving thanks always and for everything to God, the Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, submitting to one another out of reverence for Christ. This is signs or evidence of the Spirit of God, the filling of the Spirit in you and I. The first sign is fellowship, addressing one another with psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs. Now, we might not be able to do that now in person, but we must still contend for it. At the very least, do that in your gospel communities every week. Contend for fellowship. Another one is singing to God. Sing and make melody in your heart. Another evidence is gratitude for all things all the time. Give thanks always for everything that you have. And lastly, Paul says, the evidence of being filled with the Spirit is mutual submission. Submit to one another out of reverence for Christ. Prefer the other person over yourself. So then how may we be filled with the Spirit? How do we be filled with the Spirit? Firstly, I'd say, keep a clean heart. Sin grieves the Holy Spirit. Ephesians 4 and verse 30. Turn back a page in your Bibles. You're in Ephesians 5. Turn back to Ephesians 4. He says this, verse 30. Do not grieve the Holy Spirit of God, by whom you were sealed for the day of redemption. Let all bitterness and wrath and anger and clamor and slander be put away from you, along with all malice. Secondly, how are we filled with the Spirit? We should pray for it. Luke 11 and verse 13. Jesus says this, if you then, who are evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will the Heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to those who ask him? This petition from Jesus forms part of an instruction on persistence and perseverance in prayer that began back in chapter 11. That we are to repeatedly and persistently on every needful occasion to keep asking, keep seeking, keep knocking for fresh impartations of the Spirit's power. Thirdly, how are we to be filled with the Spirit? We are to walk in step with the Spirit. Galatians 5 and verse 25. Paul writes to them, he says, if we live by the Spirit, let us also keep in step with the Spirit. We are filled with the Spirit by being sensitive to his leading and to his prompting, always pursuing the presence of God. Fourthly and lastly, how we are filled with the Spirit is that we are to thirst after Jesus. John chapter 7 and verse 37. On the last day of the feast, the great day, Jesus stood up and cried out, if anyone thirsts, let him come to me and drink. Whoever believes in me, as the scripture has said, out of his heart will flow rivers of living waters. And lastly, being filled with the Spirit is a sovereign work of God. As the people of God walk in obedience to him and we make ourselves available to be used by God, he will fill us according to our need. And so as I land today, Why did we do a sermon on being a Spirit-led, Spirit-filled, and Spirit-empowered people? Well, because our desire is that we all seek to live this way. That we live lives reliant on the grace of God, but also lives demonstrating the power of God. We want to see the gifts of the Holy Spirit more at work, not just in our Sunday gatherings, but in your everyday life. Ask daily that God would fill you with the power of His Spirit. Ask that the Holy Spirit would give you gifts of prophecy so that you could build up and encourage the people of God. Ask the Spirit to give you the gift of faith and healing. Ask Him to gift you with the gift of generosity. Ask Him to gift you with the gift of tongues. Let's be men and women who live by the Spirit. You know, I wish we were all together in one room, because right now I would invite you all to respond by coming forward, and so we can pray for one another. But God is bigger than our distance that separates you and I. And so this morning, if you want a fresh filling of the Spirit of God, right now, where you sit, I want you to close your eyes. And the reason why I ask you to close your eyes is that it just helps to kind of block out the distraction of what's happening around you. I know if you've got small kids, hopefully the house won't be set on fire. Or maybe it's just really difficult to close your eyes when kids are going mental. But if you can, close your eyes just for a moment, just to block out the distraction from what's going on. Why don't you raise your hands, just turn your palms up. It's as a posture of surrender, a posture of receiving. And right now, just in your own words, ask. Ask God that He would fill you afresh with His Spirit, that He would anoint you with and by His Spirit, that He would empower you to live in step with the Spirit. He would open up your ears and your eyes so that you would hear and see what He is doing in you. Right now, where you are, do that. Ask. Keep your eyes closed. If this morning or today you desire not just the filling of His Spirit, but you also desire the gifts of the Spirit. At the very least, Paul says, eagerly desire the gifts, especially prophecy. And right now, this morning, right where you sit, your eyes closed and your hands up, pray with me right now. Heavenly Father, we thank You for Your generous work of salvation in us. And we rejoice in knowing that Your precious Holy Spirit now abides permanently in us. Lord, we also know that You alone can empower us for ministry. And so this morning we say that we have a desire for Your spiritual gifts. If you know which spiritual gift it is that you desire, why don't you say that now? Lord, we desire the gift of and Lord, we hope that this is the work of the Spirit in our hearts. And so we ask now that You would graciously impart this gift to us and grant us the immediate opportunity to exercise this gift for the building up of others and the praise and the honor of Your Son, Jesus. Amen. Amen. As we move now just to a time of worship in response, let's lean in as we sing. If you have joined us this morning and you're not yet a Christian, and what you have heard has made you inquisitive, please hit the prayer button. There is someone that's waiting to chat with you. Or maybe this is your day. This is the day where you get baptized in the Spirit, the day that you come to Christ and His Spirit makes His home in you. Hit the button that says, I commit my life to Jesus. It'll come up in the comments box. Someone is waiting to pray for you to be filled with the Holy Spirit that will lead you to a relationship with Jesus. If you want prayer for anything else, please hit the button. There are people waiting to pray for you. We can arrange a Zoom call. It doesn't have to be over like messaging and text. Someone can phone you, do a video call. We want to pray with you. We want you to experience the Spirit of God. We want you to come to faith in Jesus, to be baptized in the Spirit. We want you to be filled with the Spirit, empowered by the Spirit. And so please, maybe someone's next to you on the couch. You're in a house with other people. Ask them, pray with me now, please. Lay your hands upon me. Let's do that. Thanks, Joel. Joel's going to lead us in a song in response. As he's worshiping, as he's singing, pray. Close your eyes. Sing if you want. Just be quiet before the Lord. Ask someone to pray with you. Let's engage. Let's do this thing that we can't exactly do in person, but we can hopefully do with technology. Bless you guys. Love you. Miss you. Can't wait to meet visitors. Some of you that have been visiting us for quite a while. I haven't met you. I can't wait to meet you. We look forward to in-person gatherings. Watch this space and have an awesome, Spirit-filled, Spirit-empowered week. Bless you guys. Thanks, Joel.
You give life, you are love, you bring light to the darkness, you give hope, you restore every heart that is broken. Great are you, Lord.
You give life.
Give life, you are love, you bring light to the darkness, you give hope, you restore every heart that is broken. Great.
You give life.
You give life. You are love. You bring light to the darkness. You give hope. You restore every heart that is broken. Great. Praise to you all.
all the earth.
All the earth will shout your praise. Our hearts will cry. These bones will sing. Shout your praise. Our hearts will cry. These bones will sing. It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise, pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise to you only. It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise, pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise to you only. Great are you, Lord, to you only. Great are you, Lord.
Yes, Lord. You are great. You're awesome in all of your works. Holy Spirit, will you come and fill us? Come and anoint us. Come and give us strength. And come and give us a heart full of desire and passion to follow hard after you in these times. Lord, will you be with us? And go before us this week. Help us to walk in step with you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thanks, Joel. Thanks for leading us in our worship this morning. It's been really good to be here, and it's been good to join you online, making much of Jesus this morning. I just pray that Mike's word has maybe impacted on your heart. We've been able to sing our worship and our praises to God as well. So thanks, guys, for doing that for us this morning. These services, you know, it's my first time down here this morning, and lots of work goes in here. And indeed, Joel has led us in our worship. Mike has brought our sermon to us. But there's also other there he is. There's also other guys involved as well. And the tech team who have been supporting us right the way through. We've got Andy and Matt and Felix. Give a wave, boys. That's great. Great stuff. Thank you to you three for just giving up your time and being sacrificial to help us as a church still meet together. And those who are visiting us, of course, still to find out about us as well. So thanks, guys. Yeah, have a great week. Have a blessed week. And we'll just catch up with you as we go along. Ciao, ciao. Take care.
Always something trying to steal my mood. My crazy thoughts trying to kill my groove. That's when I hear a voice whisper through the noise that brings a bigger picture into view. Whenever the clouds come into my mind, I won't forget it's you who tells the sun to shine. Every birthday, every night, every second thought about tomorrow's wasting time.
You don't know. your eyes on me. It blows my mind to think that you would know my name, and I'm adored by the King of Kings. Whenever the clouds come into my mind, I won't forget it's you who tells the sun to shine. Every word we
one time, break it down two times. Hey, listen up.
Why should I worry? Why should I care? 'Cause nobody loves me, no.
Tendency to wear me down. Am I really free if I'm thinking about only temporary things? The world screaming so loud when I'm locked in the middle of my doubt. When I'm lost in the rhythm of the crowd, I hear heaven calling me. Don't wanna be another victim, falling prey to the system. When you've called me into the kingdom. You made the soul to be glory bound. I can hardly keep my feet on the ground, 'cause I know I will be free. Lord, won't you open up the gates wide? Gonna step into a new life. No way I'm ever leaving your side. Oh. I know I am a citizen of heaven. My eternity forever is yours. To you.
Something trying to steal my mood. My crazy thoughts trying to kill my groove. That's when I hear a voice whisper through the noise that brings a bigger picture into view. Whenever the clouds come into my mind, I won't forget it's you who tells the sun to shine. Every birthday, every night, every second.
Two times, hey, listen up.
Why should I worry? Why should I care? 'Cause nobody loves me, no.
Tendency to wear me down. Am I really free if I'm thinking about only temporary things? The world screaming so loud when I'm locked in the middle of my doubt. When I'm lost in the rhythm of the crowd, I hear heaven calling me. Don't wanna be another victim, falling prey to the system. When you've called me into the kingdom. You made the soul to be glory bound. I can hardly keep my feet on the ground, 'cause I know I will be free. Lord, won't you open up the gates wide? Gonna step into a new life. No way I'm ever leaving your side. Oh.
always something trying to steal my mood. My crazy thoughts trying to kill my groove. That's when I hear a voice whisper through the noise that brings a bigger picture into view. Whenever the clouds come into my mind, I won't forget it's you who tells the sun to shine. Every birthday, every night, every second thought about tomorrow, space and time.
Two times, hey, listen up.
Why should I worry? Why should I care? 'Cause nobody loves me, no.
Tendency to wear me down. Am I really free if I'm thinking about only temporary things? The world screaming so loud when I'm locked in the middle of my doubt. When I'm lost in the rhythm of the crowd, I hear heaven calling me. Don't wanna be another victim, falling prey to the system. When you've come into the kingdom. Clouds. You made the soul to be glory bound. I can hardly keep my feet on the ground, 'cause I know I will be free. Lord, won't you open up the gates wide? Gonna step into a new life. No way I'm ever leaving your side. Oh. I know I am a citizen of heaven. My eternity forever.
Yeah. always something trying to steal my mood. My crazy thoughts trying to kill my groove. That's when I hear a voice whisper through the noise that brings a bigger picture into view. Whenever the clouds come into my mind, I won't forget it's you who tells the sun to shine. Every morning, every night, every second thought about tomorrow's wasting time. Choose to set your eyes on me. It blows my mind to think that you would know my name, and I'm adored by the King of Kings. Whenever the clouds come into my mind, I won't forget it's you who tells the sun to shine. Every word, every night, every second thought about tomorrow's wasting time.
One time, break it down two times. Hey, listen up.
Why should I worry? Why should I care? 'Cause nobody loves me, no. Like you love me. Why should I worry? No. Why should I care? Every second thought about tomorrow's wasting time.
Tennessee to wear me down. Am I really free if I'm thinking about only temporary things? The world screaming so loud when I'm locked in the middle of my doubt. When I'm lost in the rhythm of the crowd, I hear heaven calling me. Don't wanna be another victim, falling prey to the system. When you've come into the kingdom.
You made the soul to be glory bound. I can hardly keep my feet on the ground, 'cause I know I will be free. Lord, won't you open up the gates wide? Gonna step into a new life. No way I'm ever leaving your side.